Hey guys, JP Herbing here, and I'll be showing you how to set up a cage and care for bullfrogs and leopard frogs. So one of the first things that you need is the tank. Now for a single adult American bullfrog, I recommend a 40-gallon tank. Now for leopard frogs, an adult would be a 20-gallon. Now with the younger ones, you can house the younger ones together, but you do not want to house adults together. So that's the same thing with leopard frogs too. Now the substrate. You do not want to use anything that's dry or anything. You don't want to use sand, and you don't want to use like aspen fiber or, well, you could use coconut fiber. That actually will work. But I use a mix between coconut fiber and this cypress mulch, I think. Then also have some of this moss in here. I forgot what the name was, but I think it's called like, I can't remember, but this works really well. It obtains humidity pretty well, and it also is very good for springtails. And this is a very, like, well set up enclosure for, I have two bullfrogs, and I have, well, he's probably in the water right now. He's chilling. Yeah, he's down there. You might can see him. It's that little bronze color, maybe. I don't know. But that's a mix between a leopard frog and a bronze frog. And this is a really cool looking bronze. I'll get him out in a second and show you. He usually goes underneath here. You see his little spot, or he'll go underneath here. And then there's nothing really underneath here. Some of my cricket frogs like to hang up in there. And then this is mainly just like an extra water bowl right there. And then this is also an extra water bowl. And yeah, so I do give them a lot of hides. A lot of hides is good, and also they need to be wet at all times. So that's why this is all wet. Squeeze it, look, the water's like dripping down all over me. It's wet in that big, big water tub, which is about 3 inches deep. And then underneath this rock are my two American bullfrogs. And they eat just fine. They eat calcium dusted superworms, and they just love them just fine. Same thing with the leopard frog. Now I do have two cricket frogs down there. I just kind of gave them some of the worms to see what they'd eat. Okay, let me see if I can zoom in. See if we see one right there, and the other one should be right there. That will focus. Kinda. But yeah, I have about 15 in here, and I just put fruit flies in every day, but they're usually underneath all this moss and stuff because I love to dig the cricket frogs for some reason. And I definitely get plenty of this moss. They're all up in here and stuff. I also have springtails in here, and the cricket frogs, they will eat the springtails, but the springtails are multiplied faster. So yeah, and I just heard something move. So for the temperatures, honestly, you don't want like a basking spot there. Fine with, you know, pretty good temperatures. I just give like an extra UV light, and yeah, cause I just get it's basically sunlight. And I mean, yeah, this is like the entire enclosure. This is the 40-gallon. This is what I used to keep my baby bearded dragon in, and that's his old hide. But yeah. This is decently expensive for this whole thing because the 40-gallon, this was bought like 7 years ago from my old bearded dragon, and it was like a good amount of money for this whole enclosure because it was 7 years ago. But I mean, yeah, like they're not gonna swallow any of this, and even if they do, it's okay, but not like the big pieces, they'll spit that out. But I mean, this is basically it. I mean, the hides, make sure to get them some good hides and stuff. Don't make the hides too big, too small. Just make them pretty comfortable. Make sure they have deep enough substrate to bury, because they're kind of like to sit themselves down like that. And they'll kind of poke out. But yeah, that's what my leopard frog likes to do. And then, the food. Crickets are good, soupworms are good, mealworms are occasional treats, waxworms are occasional treats, hornworms occasional treats, etc. And I'll go over a feeder insect, which one's the best and stuff. Now, dubia roaches and stuff, I've never had mine eat any sort of roach, so that's just me. They must not like it or something, I don't know. And I mean, you know, the water that is clean, it just has some coconut fiber in it. Let me see if I can show y'all the leopard frog, if he doesn't want to. Thing is, he's not like being held, but he eats just fine. He's really soft, too. This is really stirring up the water. There we go. Let me get him real quick. He's a little jumpy. Try not to hurt him or anything. But yeah, that's him. He likes to just kind of go down. But yeah, let me wash up my hands real quick. And then, I mean, this is really simple. They're fun pets, but they're amphibians. They do not like to be held that much. But yeah, I would definitely say that if you handle them, get them out, they'll be fine. But not like every day. That'll stress them out. But I mean, humidity up, the temperature not too high, not too low, and like 80, 75, low 60, you know. And I don't really have a cool or hot side because it's UV, but this stays like a gradient temperature of around 79-80. Right there. That's my temperature. And, I mean, to be honest, this thing is just like, yeah, it's pretty simple. It's fun to watch them eat. Well, I don't really get to watch them eat that much. Kind of just put the food in right there, and then occasionally I feel their bellies and see if I feel anything. And the bullfrogs ate, the bronze frog did not eat today, but the old leopard frog. And it probably eat tomorrow, the next day. I usually offer them food every day because, I mean, I just make sure that they're eating really. They don't usually eat it every day, but they usually eat it around every 3 days. Now, with feeding for cricket frogs, you want to feed them every day because they're very active. Except the ones in my tank right now, for some reason they like to dig and just chill. But there's an end right here. No, there's usually someone right there and like underneath this stuff. But right now there's only two that are really out and only two that want to eat. But I have a finger that kind of covered it. But I mean, there's not much to it. You don't really want a heat lamp. And once the bullfrogs get older, I will probably have more water because they like to swim a lot, and I'll be offering them much more food. And yeah, I mean, again, you don't want to get them too small of a food item, too big. It's just pretty simple. I mean, these guys are just chill, unless you get them wild caught. That's a problem. If you get them wild caught, they will not eat. But yeah, I've tried. So, but yeah, I mean, simple setup. It's on a shelf. I mean, I don't know what more to say about it, but there's probably going to be videos posted probably mostly on weekends because I'm busy with some stuff in the school days. But to be honest, this is really simple. It's just work with them. I'd rather get them as babies rather than adults, because adults maybe, you know, have, you know, scratches on them or something. But these things are pretty chill. So yeah. Bye, I guess.